22, November 1969, Saturday. We found a well-used trail with wooden steps going up this really steep hill. If it wasn't for the miserable rain, we might find some NVA. 25, November 1969, Tuesday. End of mission. We had a real freak show on the landing zone. Lieutenant Johnson said he was on his way to Exphyllis, so we blew down two trees with claymores and fired a LRRP rocket. Johnson didn't show until 4 hours later. Good thing the NVA were hiding from the rain. Was neat to see what a claymore does to a tree, though. 4, December 1969, Thursday. I left for Mac V. Rocando School today with Al DeBravo, a white guy from Harlem, Charlie Keough, Mark Martin from Connecticut, and Dave Casey. We made it to Cameron Bay today. Al is a pretty neat guy. He stands 6'5 and is a mean son of a gun. He said we're going to get us rooms at a hotel in Nha Trang this weekend and get us some girls. 5, December 1969, Friday. We arrived at Nha Trang and we all got rooms at the Nha Trang Hotel. We then went around to some whorehouses and each got a girl for the night. Mine's name is Cam, from Cambodia. She's a real chump. I'll get rid of her tomorrow. 6, December 1969, Saturday. I got rid of Cam and went around to 5 different houses until I finally picked Mai, also from Cambodia. She's really pretty and very polite. She treats me like I'm the only one in the world. Al and his girl and Mai and I toured Nha Trang together. We went to the beaches and all over the town. We had a great time. We then went to a movie, and Al and I were the only round eyes in the theater. I thought we might get into a fight, but it didn't develop. The movies were in Vietnamese with American subtitles. It was fun. Mai wants me to come back and see her when I get out of school. 7, December 1969, Sunday. We reported to school today. It's run by SF, and all of the instructors are former command and control recon team members. Nha Trang is SF headquarters. We were divided into recon teams, and I'm assistant team leader of my recon team. My instructor is SFC, Sergeant First Class, Pay Grade E7, Thompson. One of the guys on my recon team is this black guy, Spec 4 John Sherman, a Ranger from N Company 75th Infantry, Ranger, attached to the 173rd Airborne. We became very good friends. He's our point man. Only Rangers, Special Forces, SEALs, and Marine Corps Force Recon, and like that, go to this school. 9, December 1969, Tuesday. From 0500 to 0600 is PT. We run with 30-pound rucks, rifle, and web gear. We run a mile, increasing a mile each day until we're running 7 miles. But because of Christmas, we'll only have to run 4 miles. I carry 32 magazines on my web gear, where most carry about 21 magazines. The extra weight is heavy. 12, December 1969, Friday. I don't think I'm going to finish this school. I'm 5th in the run and in the top 5% in PT, but my classroom work sucks. I can't seem to get into the classwork. I was never good in school anyway. And even though I'm really into what's being taught, I'm having a hard time buckling down. I have a hard time paying attention. There are 2 phase exams, with phase 1 coming up on the 14th. I have to pass the phase 1. 15, December 1969, Monday. Well, I passed the phase 1 with an 86%, but I only have a 69% average. You have to have at least a 70% to stay. They were going to kick me out, but I've been put on trial. But only because physically I've been impressive. I've moved to 3rd physically, and I was told that the 101st Rangers have a great reputation with the school. Anyway, it's Christmas, and I have potential. It's also my birthday on graduation day. 23, December 1969, Tuesday. Graduated from Rocando School. It was a lot of fun, but real hard for me. I struggled through the classwork, but ended with an 85%. John Sherman really helped me with the classwork. I excelled in the PT and in the bush exercise. We went on a 3-day mission on Han Che Island, but it was a dud. There was supposed to be a sapper unit on the island, but I think they just told us that to keep our interest. A lieutenant from the 1st Cav Rangers got best student and won the Gerber Commando knife, given as a prize to the best student. John and I didn't think he was so great. He didn't show us anything tactics-wise. All he was gung-ho. I went to the SFHQ and asked about joining CCN, Command and Control North. They said they've changed commanding officers and are running their recon teams with 4 or 5 indigenous and 1 American. They're pulling the same kind of missions we are, but they get to cross the border into Laos, and they work with Yards, indigenous mountain peoples, and Nungs, Chinese. I decided to stay with the Rangers. I feel that if I go now, I'd be letting the Rangers down. Rangers don't leave Rangers behind. The guys went to Saigon for a few days, but I caught a flight to Phu Bai and then rode into Eagle. I didn't want to go to Saigon because I felt like I was gonna miss out on something. Pretty stupid. But I just want to go out to the bush. My recon team goes out tomorrow, as a matter of fact. Good timing. My birthday, 20. 24 December 1969, Wednesday. 12th Mission, Mercury, YD-3602. Heavy with Horn's recon team. My brother Jeff's birthday, 14. 25 December 1969, Thursday. Merry Christmas. May God be with us and protect us the rest of our tour. 26 December 1969, Friday. Rodarte's recon team made contact 2 clicks from us. No KIA. Bob Hope came to Eagle today, but I'm here on this dud of a mission missing the show. If I'd gone to Saigon with the guys after Rokondo school, I would have been able to see Bob Hope. Bob Hope is one of the attractions I wanted to see while I was in Vietnam, but I missed it over this dud mission. 27 December 1969, Saturday. End of mission. We found 3 NVA campsites, 1 U.S. fragmentation grenade, and 2 U.S. helmets. There were a lot of signs, but no NVA. 2 January 1970, Friday. 13th Mission Excalibur, YD-0531. We're heavy with Sergeant Dave Bennett's recon team. Bennett is from Huntington Beach, California. He's supposed to be one of the best on the radio. In one big contact his recon team had gotten into, Dave was running and ran right into a tree and knocked himself out. He got a purple heart. 8 January 1970, Thursday. End of a miserable 7 days. It rained most of the time. But we did have a lot of fruit in the area of operations. Was a lot of banana trees and a fresh-running creek. Was a beautiful area of operations. This was Drodd's and Bennett's last mission. They leave country in less than 30 days. I'll miss Drodd. He's a pretty funny dude and was pretty good to us. I learned some things from him. Dave Weeks' recon team made contact 2 today. First, they didn't get any KIA, but on their 2nd contact, they got 1 KIA. Everybody around us made contact but us. 11 January 1970, Sunday. A very sad day for us. Staff Sergeant Salter's recon team made contact today. It was raining real hard and was pretty cold, so they were heating up some cocoa when the NVA snuck up on them and opened up. KIA Salters, the team leader, and Jones, the assistant team leader. It was pretty hairy for a while because the recon team was unable to exfil because of the low clouds and rain. A low finally was able to get the recon team out, but could only take 2 guys at a time. When it got down to the last 3 guys, Sergeant Brown was forced to stay behind by himself. He was put in for the Distinguished Service Cross, along with the low pilot, who did a fantastic job. The whole recon team freaked, and only the coolness of the low pilot saved them. When Brown was left by himself, he had attempted to grab the skids of the low, but the low wouldn't get up because of the weight of the 3 extra guys, so the gunner had to kick Brown off the skids. So Brown didn't volunteer to stay behind. He was kicked off the low and forced to stay. That doesn't deserve a medal. What he did was not an act of bravery. They were all lucky to be alive. That was Jones's first and last mission.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.